So I get comments all the time like, do Speak Now, react to Speak Now, and I've basically heard every single song. I've heard about like 11 of the songs, I think, other than I haven't heard Never Grow Up, Innocent. I believe there's one more song that I haven't heard. So in this video, I'm just gonna be finishing up the Speak Now album, the songs I haven't heard from it. The rest of the songs, of course, I've done just over the time doing Taylor Swift content on my channel. Done, you know, music videos or a live performance, you know, just however, like, I've done all the rest of the songs, so definitely check those out if you haven't already. But yeah, I'm super excited to finish up Speak Now. If you're new here, definitely subscribe and click the like button. Check my Patreon if you'll support the channel further. I hope everyone's having a great day. And yeah, we're checking out Never Grow Up. I thought I'd do a lyric video because I don't know, I enjoy doing lyric videos, so even though they're probably gonna be misspelled, I almost guarantee there's gonna be one word misspelled and it's gonna bother me. Okay, let's do this. By the way, Speak Now, low-key, I was looking just like at the songs on it when I before just to see what songs I've heard. All the song, like, this is an incredible album, by the way. No one really, like, nobody really talks about it. That's like how good her other albums are, because like my personal favorite, 1989, it's like this one is actually super good, by the way, too. It's super good.
Your little hands wrapped around my finger, and it's so quiet in the world tonight. Your little eyelids flutter cause you're dreaming, so I tuck you in, turn on your favorite nightlight.
So clearly she's singing about like if she had a kid, right? And never grow up.
To you, everything's funny. You got nothing to regret. I'd give all I have, honey, you could stay like that. Oh, darling, don't you ever grow up. Don't you ever grow up. Just stay this little. Oh, darling, don't you ever grow up. Don't you ever grow up. It could stay this simple.
Dude, this is really good. I love it. It's such a cute song. This really is one of her cutest songs ever. I thought it was going to be from her point of view about her not wanting to grow up, because this is like when she was way younger, like doing this album. I thought it was going to be her like not talking about never, and it's like, you know, her seeing basically if she had like, you know, maybe she's doing it from a different point of view, but basically if she had like a kid, and like, I love that, like, don't you ever grow up, it could stay this simple, and just like, you have no regrets. It's so true, dude. It's so wild how much of your childhood you're wishing you're older, because it seems like you can do all this cool stuff, which you can, but it's like, dude, it's way better as a kid. Low-key, like, I miss, like, I wish I could be like 8 again. You know, I guess not all of us have like a great childhood, so I guess not like all of us could be like, oh, I wish I was doing that, or I wish I was. So it is like better for people to grow up, but like, dude, like, you know, I was blessed, man. I wish, and all your parents out there, I feel like this would be a really cool song. Like, if you have a kid, I feel like this would be like a really cute song to listen to, and like while you're like, and like really nostalgic too, if like, what if your kid is already grown, kind of. This is, dude, this is cute. I love this, actually.
I won't let nobody hurt you. No one break your heart.
Dude, her vocals
no
on it.
Will desert you.
Aw, this is such a sweet song.
Never grow up.
I want to cry, bro. This is so good. This is really cute.
Never grow up. You're in the car on the way to the movies, and you're mortified your mom's dropping you off at 14. There's just so much you can't.
So it's like he's like, or the kid's like kind of like growing up now. Like, it was like, you know, you're like, your hands are too small, and now it's like they're 14 and they're like kind of growing. They're seeing just so much. Oh my, this is so perfect, dude. Oh my,
you can't wait to move out someday and call your own shots.
This is,
but don't make her drop you off around the block. Remember that she's getting older too.
Oh,
don't
my
lose
God.
The way that you dance around in your PJs getting ready for school. Oh, darling, don't you ever grow up.
I absolutely love the way she like fits that into about how like your mom, like, you know, she's like, your mom's growing up and like you're gonna regret all those. But it's like, dude, it's like sucks because like, you know, it's like people are hard on themselves when it like, when like if your like mother passed away and like you did that, but like, you know, you're like, we're all kids, like, it's like, no, you can't, Like, you can't, like, just, you know, that's just kids. Like, kids do that. They get embarrassed by their parents or whatever, wherever that may be. Like, you know, that's why you can't be hard. It's like every kid, really. Like, that's just being a kid. You didn't know any better, you know? But that's what growing up is realizing, like, those moments you have with your parents or, you know, whoever's close with you and, like, you know, taking the... This is a beautiful song, dude. Absolutely, dude. Speak Now album is a really good album. Low key it could be my favorite, honestly. It is a really good damn album, dude. I absolutely love this song.
Don't you ever grow up, just stay this little. Oh darling, don't you ever grow up, don't you ever grow up. It could stay this simple, and no one's ever burned you, nothing's ever left you scarred.
Dude, the fact that she could make a song like this so young is just, I love that little accent too. Like, she has like a really, like, old nice little country accent. It's really cute. No, dude, no one's ever burned. Dude, this is such like it's so sad, but it's also like cute at the same time. You know what I mean? Like, this is such a sad song, honestly. It really is a sad song.
And even though you want to, just try to never grow up.
It's so slow. It's like slow burning, dude. I feel like I'm in a suspense film.
Take pictures in your mind of your childhood room.
Oh, shit. I really like that hum actually right there. That was really good. Dude, this song is fire. Okay, that was really good.
Memorize what it sounded like when your dad gets home. Favorite songs. I just realized everything I have is someday gonna be gone.
Dude, I got chills by that line.
Here I am in my new apartment.
So it is, I guess, from her point. It is like still technically, because like, so it's like technically from her point of view, but kind of like her growing up. And I wonder if like, if does she have a, I don't know why, but I don't know. Does she have a little brother? I don't even know if she has. Why have I not gotten into that? Please comment. But I haven't gotten into like any of her, like, if she's brother or sister. Why have I never known that? Please let me know. That's new to me, actually. Let me know. Does Taylor Swift have a brother or sister? I have no idea. But yeah, I absolutely love that. Like, so here I'm in a new apartment. I'm in a big city. Was this when she, because I thought she went to New York for Red, but she might have been, this might have been going to Nashville. Right, because she's from, but so for some reason I get confused that she didn't grow up in Tennessee. I say this sometimes in videos, I apologize. She grew up in Pennsylvania on the, you know, Christmas tree farm. I understand that, but I wonder if she means like Nashville is in the big city, because I guess that is like, if you're in like a in the, you know, in the country in Pennsylvania and you move to Nashville is a bigger, like, big city to that. But I don't know if she'd be in New York at this point. Let me know. Dude, this is such a good song, man. This is such a good song.
Big city, they just dropped me off. It's so much colder than I thought it would be, so I tucked myself in and turned my nightlight on.
I like how is the mom tucking the kid in and like turning the nightlight on, and now it's her in her own apartment turning the nightlight on. Like, I love the way she is able to have story progression within a song within just a 4 minutes is spectacular, and I absolutely love it. Like, this, it feels like I'm watching a movie, dude. Like, there's just story progression is absolutely insane. It's so insane every time.
Wish I'd never grown.
See, I absolutely love it. Now it's like her saying, wish I, dude, it's so good. This is like a perfectly done song. Like, every part of this is perfect. It really is perfect.
Wish I'd never grown up. Oh, I don't.
It sounds like she was crying. Dude, this, if someone asked me what a perfect song is from just like a structure standpoint, this is what I'd show them. Because listen, it sounds like she's kind of like crying now too when she said that.
Wish I'd never grown up. Oh, I don't wanna grow up. Wish I'd never grown up. Could still be little. Oh, I don't wanna grow up. Wish I'd never grown up. It could still be simple. Oh, darling, don't you ever grow up. Don't
this
you
is
ever
amazing.
Grow
this
up.
This is amazing.
Just stay this little. Oh, darling, don't you ever grow up. Don't you ever grow up, can stay this simple.
Her voice is beautiful, man.
Don't you ever go. Never grow up.
That was perfect. That was a perfect song. Honestly, that was a perfect song. I think it was really cute. I think the story progression of like her, of it being like when the, you know, can't fit the hand in mom's palm, and then growing up and like her wishing she never grew up and realizing that. It's funny, like I remember always being told as a kid, oh, you don't want to grow up, it's way better as a kid. But like as a kid, you're just like, uh-huh, sure, like there's like a secret you're not in on, and you just like want to grow up so bad, and you don't even realize you're growing up. And then at a time you realize, you sit there and you're like, damn bro, I was living the life. There's no other problems, you know, like you weren't, I don't care about like what it looks or care about this, care about that. It was literally just throw on a t-shirt, pair of pants or whatever, go to school, hang out with friends, go home and play games. That was just, you know, it's so simple. You have to worry about just like relationship, just all of that, just all, it's just so much extra stuff, man. So much extra. That was a beautiful song. I absolutely love it. It's super cute. And yeah, that was amazing. I think she fit a little parts of her life. Let me know if like that new, I assume like the new apartment thing was like part of her. Like I love the way she like it was fit that into that. That was so good, man. That's so good. All right, let's do the next song. I believe it's Innocent.
We're doing Long Live.
5 minutes, 17 seconds. I noticed all like the Speak Now songs, bro, are honestly really long. All her Speak Now songs are long. Okay, this is more of an upbeat one. Nice little guitar. Got that John Mayer guitar going. She really does have that John Mayer guitar going.
I said, remember this moment in the back of my mind. The time we stood with our shaking hands, the crowds and stands went wild. We were the kings and the queens.
I really like the production in the song. The production in the song is really cool.
The night you danced like you knew our lives would never be the same.
Like I love the guitar play in the background.
You held your head like a hero on a history book page. It was the end of a decade, but the start of an age. Long live the walls we crash through. All the kingdom lights shine just for me and you. I was screaming, long live all the magic we made. And bring on all the pretenders. One day we will be remembered.
Try to figure out. Oh wait, I meant to do it, dude. I don't know why that just happened, honestly. Dude, okay, that's why I was tripping this whole time. I meant to do Innocent just now because that was gonna be next, and now the Long Live's the last song, and I just for some reason I did Long Live instead. I don't know why, and I was sitting there thinking, I'm like, what does this have to do with her being innocent? And I'm sitting there. I don't know what just happened to my brain. Okay, so now I'm understanding. Now I'm Long Live. Okay, I was like, dude, what is going on? And why is she singing about this on a song called about innocent? Okay, now it makes, dude, now everything makes sense to me. So I actually think this is really cool how she finished off the album with this song, especially like lyrics like I said, remember this feeling, etc. It's kind of like in an aspect, long live this album, and just like long live like this Speak Now is gonna live like for a long time in kind of that aspect, you know. So I think it's really cool how she saved this song for the final track in the album. I think that placement is really cool. It's pretty wild how like rock this album is, especially a song like Better Revenge. Like that song is just insane, right? This is like really like rock too. There's a lot of songs on this, Sparks Fly. There's a lot of kind of like rock songs on this album, and it's so cool. I absolutely love it. I love it, man. This is a good school song too.
Baseball cap for a crown.
So I assume she's just talking about like homecoming king queen, right? Like, or prom king queen. Do they have a prom king queen? I don't know. I never went. But if there is, then that could be. But I think it's homecoming queen because you trade your baseball cap for a crown. So I assume it's just homecoming king and queen. So obviously, like, I was never homecoming queen or homecoming king, right? But I think this is super relatable, especially if you grow up in a smaller town, because like homecoming king queen, that when that like homecoming games, especially in a smaller town like I grew up in, that is like where you're gonna be. Like, that's where like a lot of the town are, because everyone just like, you know, you'll have a small, like, I literally, my graduating class literally had maybe 200 people in it, 200 people maybe, and total like 1,000 kids are at school. So basically, if you like know someone, everyone kind of like knows somebody in this town, like you just know a lot of people. I grew up in this, and it's like, that's like such a, and she I think she grew up the like same experience, because like the Christmas tree for like the Pennsylvania, right? I believe she is a smaller area in Pennsylvania. It's such like a, we held them up for our town, like that's like legit, like you like those games, you go, like that's like you really do hold them up for your town, because there's so many people from the town that really do go to those games. So I think this is super relatable, and like how big, I don't know, like I it's weird growing up in a small town versus a big city. Big city, it's like, I don't know if it's like that anymore. Like, I feel like, you know, like people are like progressively past that, where in like small towns you kind of, you're still living in like this kind of like old high school, like has a big effect, like I don't know, you know what I mean, like kind of those old high school shows has such like a, it's like a near thing to like a high school I went to in the, like, you know, in the late 2010s. I don't know if anyone else has experienced that, but yeah. That's real. I absolutely love the production of her screaming this is absurd. See, this song, the production on this song is fire. Dude, it's so rock. This is fire. This is fire. There's a bad song on Speak Now. Legit. I don't think I've heard a song on Speak Now where I was like, I don't really like that. Like, I get like excited on every song on Speak Now. Dude, Speak Now is an incredible album. I'm now realizing. I don't know why. By the way, all those people, if you're like super popular in high school, or like you do like prom, no one's gonna remember, promise you. Like, I know she's like referring to someone else, but like in the aspect of like homecoming king queen prom, no one's gonna remember. I think I forgot, I don't even remember one person that won, but I wasn't too invested in it, but I don't think anyone remembers anyone's, unless them, yeah. I love the pop. That's so cool. This is an amazing song. Promise me this, that you'll stand by me forever. But if God forbid fate should step in and force us into a goodbye. See, I love the aspect of her adding this part in too. Like, it's not just like, oh, it's long live, we're gonna be in there for, we're gonna be together forever, we're gonna long live happy. It's like, I love this little added part of like, but that might not happen, so let me add this part of in case it doesn't happen, and what's gonna happen if it doesn't happen, you know what I mean? Like, that's so sick, and that's what makes it not like basic, because like the first beginning, like you could just say, be like, oh, that's a basic love song, or basic that, right? But like nobody else does this except Taylor Swift. Nobody, fight me. See, that's so good. It's so good. Point to the pictures. Please tell him my name. This is really good. The guitar play is insane, by the way. It really does. It really does, like, the guitar play, especially, like, because Dear John's on this album. The guitar play in Dear John's so, like, reminiscent to me to, like, John Mayer guitar play. This, like, the guitar play in this song, too, really reminds me of John Mayer, too. Which is I don't know if she, like, was, like, had a lot of inspiration from his music at that time. Which, it wouldn't be surprising, right? Because, like, you know, it's John Mayer talking to you and, like, dating you. So I wouldn't be surprised if she did have inspiration at that time. But, dude, the production on this song compared to the last song was good lyrically. Like, lyrically is just really good. But the production on this song versus that one, the production on this one is insane. Time of my life with you. See, listen to it. I think I could sit here and probably dissect and relate Taylor Swift's songs to my life, like, forever, honestly. Like, I feel like every song, which I already make, these are like 10-minute videos of a 5-minute song already, but I feel like every song I could sit here for 30 minutes, legitimately 30 minutes, and just talk and talk about one little lyric and how that relates to so many different things that I've experienced, etc., etc. That was really good. I absolutely love the production, love the guitar, but everything about this song was really, really, really good. So yeah, let's do Innocent now, which I thought we were doing at the beginning of this video. I don't know why. Okay. The last song is Innocent.
Guess you really did it this time. Left yourself in your warpath. Lost your balance on a tightrope. Lost your mind trying to get it back.
That's deep. Lost your mind trying to get it back. Lost your mind trying to get it back. Huh. Bit of a slower song.
Wasn't it easier in your lunchbox days? Always a bigger bed to crawl into.
What does she mean by that, really? Like, once it beautiful when you believed it, or no, that's the next part. Once it easier in your lunchbox days, always a bigger bed to crawl. Like, what does she mean? Like, since, like, lunchbox days, she's relating that to, like, a kid. So, like, as a kid, the bed was already bigger, or always bigger to crawl into, since you're a kid and you're, like, smaller, physically. Is that what she means? Once it easier in your lunchbox days, always a bigger bed to crawl into. Or is she meaning an aspect of, once it easier in a lunchbox days, there's always, it's easier back then, but now there's always a bigger bed to crawl into, like a bed of mess or bed of, you know, just something bad in an aspect of that. What I guess I'll find out, right? Maybe.
Bed to crawl into.
There's like two things I could go into that.
Wasn't it beautiful when you believed in everything? Everybody.
love the drums.
But at night you live it all again. You wouldn't be shattered on the floor now.
Love the drums, love the drums.
If only you had seen what you know now.
I'm trying to figure out, like, where she's, like, where we're going with this song, because I understand once it's easier in your fire. I don't know why this song's confusing me.
Firefly catching days when everything out of reach, someone bigger brought.
See, it seems like she's going, like, when you were innocent, right? Like, when, like, the kid was innocent, because she did. So I was right, like, the lunchbox and then, like, everything. When everything's out of reach, someone bigger brought it down to you. Like, so it seems like a smaller child that she using the lunchbox, but it's like the lunchbox thing, like the, that line, that sequence right there could be like a totally different aspect in what that means also at the same time. That's what the one thing confused me about Taylor Swift is, like, it always, like, she has, like, you could, like, relate two different things into one, like, one thing, and it always just, like, if you're not, like, in the same, like, same standby she's in, and you're thinking, like, you have, like, something else you just experienced a week ago, you could, like, have that fresh in your mind and just, like, think about that instead.
Down to you, wasn't it beautiful? Run wild till you fell asleep before the monsters caught up to you.
Yeah, so she's talking about a kid. That's what's confusing me. It's all right, just wait, like, this line in the relation to the rest of the song about a kid, that's what this is confusing. Like, this line is confusing.
Who you are is not where you've been. You're still an innocent. It's okay. Life is a tough crowd. 32 and still growing up now. Who you are is not what you
So it's just like she's saying, like, your experiences are still, like, you're still innocent no matter what, like, all these experiences you've gone through, because she's, like, clarifying, like, she's putting specific instances with, like, kids you'd experience, like the lunchbox and the monsters and just all those aspects, like, clearly running wild until you pass out, like, all those, like, are clear, like, kid. But, like, the this part of the song, the ending of the, like, kind of like this where it's like you're still an innocent, and yeah, that's, like, what's gonna be.
The production's really good, by the way.
Time turns flames to embers. You had new Septembers.
Oh, shit.
Every one of us has messed up too.
So this person maybe, because it seems like no matter, like, she keeps going up, like, messed up. So it must be that person messed up in some way. And, like, but she's saying, like, you're still, like, you're still innocent, even though you did whatever they did. By the way, who absolutely loves when she does that? When she does, like, the ooh, and that build up, those build ups right there, when she actually does it vocally, are so sick. It's, I love that. God, bro, why'd she go that hard right there? Is she talking about John Mayer? I don't know, because wasn't he 32? I swear this fool was 32, and she was like 19. I swear this fool is 32. I don't know, because I thought this album, like, she already has, like, Dear John and, like, I think another song, but is this about John Mayer? I don't know, because like, dude, it's so confusing, because it's like so weird, because like she brings up that 32 lyric, the string of lights thing was really confusing me. That was like the first thing, because it was like a love song, but once it a love song, but then it was like brought to kids, and then it's like, okay, so no matter, so the person made a lot of mistakes and she's understanding that, but like the person's still an innocent. Is she talking about John Mayer though? Because one's in the full 32. Still an innocent. Lost your balance on a tightrope. Dude, I've been so into like all the kid lyrics that I forgot the first verse was talking about like losing your head and bounce. Like her songs are so long. And there's so much depth to it. It's never too late to get it back. That's so sick how it's like you were losing like the beginning, it was like you're losing your mind to find your mind. And then she like adds at the end, it's never too late to get it back. Like that's so sick. That's so sick. I honestly totally forgot about the first verse because like there's I was so into trying to figure out like where she was going with like all the, so the person, I wonder if, cause like, was it John Mayer 30, who else would she be singing that? It's like 32. That's like, it's kind of like a love song, but it's kind of not, but it's like, is. Let me know your guys' thoughts on this one. The production on this was really cool. I love the drums. I love the guitar again. It was really cool. Actually, really, the production on this was really good. Yeah, those are the last three songs I've heard him speak now. And I'm now realizing, like I was looking at like just the list, dude. The list here, we just literally pulled up. So, mine, insanely good. Sparks Fly, it's like, it's good, but it's not like one of my, like, Back to December, fire. Speak Now, fire. Dear John, fire. One of my favorite videos I've ever done. Mean, fire. The Story of Us might be the best song on this album. Never Grew Up, we just did, really good. Enchanted, very good. Better Than Revenge, insane. Innocent, this was really good. Haunted, really good. Last Kiss, really good. Well, like they're all like just amazing, like they really are. Look how the length of every single song, the shortest song on this is 3 minutes and 37 seconds, dude. This is literally insane. She's a 6 minute song, like 6 minutes 43 seconds, Dear John. Like they're all so long, but they all just keep you very invested the entire time and are just well done. So yeah, that's gonna do it for Speak Now. Everyone enjoyed. I have like, I'm pretty sure I have her first. I'm gonna wait until whatchamacallit comes out, Fearless comes out, because it's already like what, like 2 weeks, 3 weeks, something, 2 weeks I think until release date. So I might as well just wait till that drop, full album drop. So I'm gonna do that. But the next album I'll be doing is like her self-titled one, I believe. But yeah, that's gonna do it. Everyone enjoyed. Let me know like your thoughts on the songs, etc. And yeah. Love reading your guys' comments. If you're new here, subscribe, click the like button, check my Patreon, Fieldsport, Chilling Firth. Thank you guys all for support. I love you guys, and I'll see you on the next.